Folks up for that. Okay, so my name is Eileen Miller, and I'll be your MC tonight, introducing act. So thank you. And first thing I want to do is tell a little bit about, everybody knows what Art for Healing is about? Okay, well, I'm going to have the founder tell you more about it. My understanding is that the organization helps performing artists, visual artists, artists of all kinds. They support them with workshops. They run different programs. We have Captain America going around with a 9/11 book. That book was done 10 years after 9/11 and was all contributed by musicians, by writers and poets, all the art. So that's something you definitely want to take a look at. It's a very nominal price on it, and you can contribute it to a public library, or you can give it as a gift, if you're a historic gift. We also have, with admission, we have a coffee table art book. Let me think what else. Let's see. We tried to get Trapeze back, but we had a little difficulty with it. So I would like to have you help me to welcome the founder and the person who put all this together, the founder of Art for Healing, Lauren Ellis. Here we go.
Action for Aging in Queens and with the mayor, Bloomberg, many years ago. So we're lucky to have her back. Let's put a hand for Eileen. Arthur Young was founded 13 years ago. We're 13, long 13 years, but our mission is to help artists, visual and performing artists, share the healing power of their art with the public in many different ways. So if we do workshops with children, the elderly, we do have our 9/11 book that's an ongoing project, which we're so happy to have Captain America here tonight. Yeah. And we have our banner. So our book is ongoing, as Eileen said. You can purchase one, donate to your local library. We have the book presently in three countries across the country, California, Florida, New York, New Jersey. It's onward. We should never forget it was a very important time of our history that we need to always remember and have peace. So also what we do is we do consultation for artists, and we like to network them. We're showcasing different artists tonight. That's our program. And you know, we showcase them so people can understand, meet different sounds, and they sell their CDs, they keep the money for their CDs. And we also have a little gallery, and we have showings, and we're going to be doing, for the next 4 weeks or 4 months, a $95 special artwork at our gallery. So look at our events section of our website always for upcoming events we're doing at the gallery. Thank you, Eileen, and welcome everybody.
So we're going to open with a ribbon international peace vigil. Whatever that is, we will find out. So please welcome the members of the International Peace Vigil. They're a non-governmental organization in association with the United Nations. And Christina Goodwin is going to play guitar during this visit. Okay, International Peace Vigil.
Throughout the world, and Michelle Peppers is speaker for the evening on behalf of the Ribbon International, and I am the organizer of the Vigil for International Peace. You are all invited 21 September to Central Park to participate at the Bencha from 9 to 5 on International Day of Peace. Michelle? Thank you.
I'll tell you just a brief history of the ribbon. The original theme was what I cannot bear to think of. The original theme was what I cannot bear to think of as lost forever in a nuclear war. 10 miles of these went around the Pentagon in 1985 and around the A-bomb memorial in Hiroshima for the 40th anniversary of the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And since then, ribbons have been made all over the world. You have ribbons here from Hiroshima, Kenya, the United States, Canada, many other parts of the world. I mean, ribbons have been made from many parts of the world. And we're a UN NGO, and people can use this project in your community. It's finding common ground with other people all over the world on what you love and care about on the earth, and joining them together. It crosses cultural and language barriers. So right now, we're going to say an interfaith prayer for peace that we use at events, ribbon events. People create ribbons at schools or places of worship, and then have an event or exhibit their ribbon. So we're going to start with the interfaith prayer for peace.
For their peace and relinquishing of self.
For our Christian brothers and sisters, for their message of love and practice of forgiveness.
For our Hindu sisters and brothers, kindly dispositions and open-hearted acceptance of others.
For our indigenous sisters and brothers' traditions, for their reverence for nature.
For our Jain brothers and sisters, for their deep respect for life and practice of nonviolence.
For our Jewish sisters and brothers, for their enriching symbols of worship and cherishing of tradition.
Truth, the yearning after love, the commitment to the justice and longing for peace. God help us all, inspire us, and every unity us. Amen.
This came from the Theosophical Order of Service, and this is just a sampling of what we can do with ribbons, and we will usually join them together with the tie, so that everybody's made a ribbon that's joined together, and it's joining together in a circle of what we care about and find common ground in.
All right, we're going to walk this way to the right now.
Okay,
let's go.
We can walk through a conference, or we've walked through parks carrying our ribbons, and that's it. We can join them.
Yeah, that's right. That's what we do.
Join them together. Yeah, in a bow, tied in a bow, and then we'll also exhibit them at places of worship, galleries, libraries. Central Park, September 21st, we'll have ribbons on display. The whole day is full of wonderful events put on by, sponsored by Susan Mastarica and her organization. Okay? And just think, somebody, you're holding in your hands what somebody loved and cared about, and they thought about and put it on a ribbon. Thank you, everyone.
Woo-hoo!
Okay, that was lovely. That was really great. And it's so important to have peace in our lives. And thank you, Ribbon Ceremony people, for doing your sampling. Thank you. Eileen?
Yeah! Yay! All right, please, Miller.
Yes, we're going to welcome back Eileen Miller, our MC for tonight. Thank you. She's going to do a little stand-up comedy for us. We need laughter in our life. Laughter is important for healing. Thank you, Eileen.
Okay, let me hear it for the ribbon peace ceremony. Yeah. offer. But I'm a little worried because of the way we treat old people in this country. Yeah, we treat them like they did something wrong. Hey, you're old. How'd you let that happen? Why don't you do something about it? Yeah, really. And even in accident, we blame on people's age. Like, woman, 56, gets hit by Mack truck. Man, 67, falls down elevator shaft. And we think, what do we think? Well, they were old. I don't think we think that. Yeah, as if a young person would have bounced off the Mack truck or could have hung down the elevator shaft like Spider-Man. So listen, if you're young or not so young, stop ridiculing older people because you're lucky if you get to be one, right? Yeah. And we won't be in the majority soon, and we'll be making the rules. So, we'll get revenge. How would you like driving a maximum speed of 25 miles an hour? Having dinner at 4:30 in the afternoon. Yeah. Really. All the bars would close at 9 p.m. Anyway. And the worst is, you know those cell phones everybody all love? We'll make texting so expensive, you'll actually have to talk to people. Really. You know? And they're going to be so big you'll need wheels. The ringtone will be so loud, Helen Keller could have heard on it. And the buttons will be so big, you could text with your elbows. You know, that's it. So anyway, I have a question for the women. Hello, hello, women. Question for the women. There you go. You listen. You remember when you were little girls, how excited you were about getting older? And how thrilled you were when all your body changes. Ooh, boobies, hair, ooh, yeah. Well, the thrill is gone now, isn't it? Yeah. Now, we're afraid to look in the mirror. We really are, because we'll find some kind of a blemish or wrinkle the Hubble telescope couldn't find, really. You know? But the thing, you guys don't care about that. Watch parts in the silent auction. What else am I?
by getting that. Captain America is going around with the book. I think it's only $20. You can donate to your public library. So without further ado, I am going to introduce our next solo artist. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me see what I want to say about it then. Excuse me. Okay. Elena is a singer and songwriter doing an original song for you tonight. So would you please welcome to the stage Elena Giordani. She needs a little time to set up. Okay. What is it you need? Perfect time for you to get a drink, get on something, get a wrap. I think you got a pedicure or a manicure outside.
Sometimes hard to sleep alike when you're standing at the bottom of the game.
Okay, somebody answer me. Are there any raffle tickets in the hat?
No.
Okay. Well, you would have won if you had one in there. Just one. Good question. $5. Okay. So while the next act is setting up, what else do we have? Yes, I told you the tickets are 2 for $5. No, 2 for $5 and 6 for $10. Okay. All right. Okay, has anybody, have you had a chance to look at the silent auction? See all the beautiful artwork and jewelry? Can we go here? All these people are set up.
You're on, Alan.
Thank
you. Thank you.
Okay, while they're setting up, how much more time do you need? 5 minutes? Okay, I'm going to introduce. Are you ready? Sarah, also, give me a
the girls are tumbling.
We only need a minute.